rest, but we've got some football to keep us warm at Gillette Stadium in Foxborough. Tonight, we polish off Week 10 with a good Monday night matchup between the Cincinnati Bengals and the New England Patriots. The shadow's starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Here's Burrow. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 19 yards right off the bat. And a quick first down.
Good job there to locate his tight end, Charles, in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass-catching abilities. And if they're able to continue to find him here in the early going, I think it'll help out his teammates out on the perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he occupies their attention.
So the completion results there in 9 yards. And they'll have a second and one forthcoming. Off the play fake, here's Burrow, rolling to his left. Finding a safety valve here, that's complete.
And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line.
I like it, I like it, I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Leighton Vander Esch. And the Patriots are going to have the football here at their own 18-yard line. Well, it's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions, can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
Just a simple tap pass, but it pays off in a big way.
And sometimes the simple stuff causes the most problems for a defense because there's a breakdown in communication there. When that receiver goes behind the line of scrimmage and it looks like he's going in motion, someone either has to go with him or he has to be passed off to another defender. Somehow they didn't get that communicated well, and it turned into a nice play.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
Check.
Now back to throw. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
The Patriots at 4-5, a game under 500. Charles, they were losers last time out. What do you think they need to do differently here?
Well, I don't think it needs to be as drastic as burning up last week's game tape or not watching it, but the attitude has to be what's done is done. Let's move on. Put that one behind them, galvanize themselves, and go forward and get a win in this one.
Well, this defense for the Bengals, they were excellent last week in the win over the Chargers.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. Harris running straight ahead. And he's got Rome past the 20. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2.
50 yards rushing for him now as he has gotten the night off to a hot start.
First and goal, a chance to convert that early turnover into points. Harris is not going to get back to the line of scrimmage as they'll tackle him at the 3.
That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
They'll try to run with Harris. And he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score. Damian Harris, his seventh rushing touchdown of the year. And the Patriots take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Here we go, here we go.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And through an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Now it's Burrow. Another one into the hands of Ja'Marr Chase. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Consecutive catches for him. That good for 11.
I like that one, partner. They go back-to-back with excellent gains. And really, it shouldn't be a surprise who they were throwing the ball to. He's their best guy.
Yeah, we knew that they would get him involved early. They're doubling down on getting him involved early.
Don't be surprised if they'll come right back to him again. They haven't shown the propensity to be able to stop him.
And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35.
My goodness, they've come out locked in on this drive. Play calling, execution, they are fully in sync.
Here we go.
Three straight passes, three first downs. They're moving the ball downfield almost at will. This defense really struggling to find answers.
Burrow's throw caught by Higgins. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
No gain on the play there. It'll be second down.
If you're a wide receiver and they call a screen pass, you're counting on some people being out in front of you blocking. And that play was well diagnosed by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. And they got there and swarmed and finished off the play.
On the ground, this is Joe Mixon. And he's brought down, but not before a really nice stiff arm to create a little space. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing, because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Here we go, here we go.
Burrow will throw. And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. A great effort there. His first touchdown on the year. And the Bengals are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. We'll see a return here from the end zone. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. And they dipped a game below 500 following the loss last week. And you get the sense that maybe this team's at a little bit of a crossroads here.
He's got a man complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 39 yards there, a big one.
As we've seen over the years, offensive coordinators will often ease their way into drives. Many of them don't want to risk a turnover, put their defense in a bad spot, but not in this case.
Not at all. Forget about easing into it. They took a shot. It worked. And a pretty good burst right there as he'll take this down to the 33. 61 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in his first half. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. He gets it complete to Harris. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line.
And they'll use him out of the backfield, and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. Four catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
On second down, this is Harris. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
But they're getting ready to go to work now in prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot and picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. First down, and they go back to Harris. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
And that's exactly what offenses try to avoid by using motion and throwing different formations up. They hate when he can draw a bead on the play, get a running start, and make a big play behind the line of scrimmage as he did just there.
On second and 12, Hurts. And he rifles one incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. They'll drop the throw. He's got his man, Thornton. Touchdown, Patriots. Tyquan Thornton, his second touchdown on the season. And the Patriots have moved out in front. Extra point right down the middle. And that makes the score 14-7. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown.
Here we go.
The Bengals drive about to get going. Just the one misstep for them in the first half of the season. 7-1 is the record at the midway point. And in terms of whatever power rankings you want to go by, they're at or near the top of the list in terms of best teams in the National Football League.
And for me, in my little bit of rankings here, I've got them at the top. I know there's still 2 months to go, and we've seen teams get off to hot starts and then fade away due to injuries or the schedule or whatever. But unless there are a rash of injuries on this team, I'd be surprised if they aren't a first or a second seed come playoff time.
And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
Everyone has their strengths, able to move to their right or their left, being able to throw the football. So that means you've got to work on both, because you never know which way you're going to get flushed by pressure. In this situation, able to escape to his left and makes an accurate throw.
And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. That one good for 15, and the Bengals get a first down.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Throwing now, Burrow on first down. Looking for Chase on the out route. He's got him. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. 12 more yards there and another first down. Now Burrow. And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete.
Nice progress down the field was halted by that incompletion. They could try for some safe yards here to get things moving again, or keep throwing it and pushing it downfield to try and pick up bigger yardage.
On second down, here's Mixon.
And he's going to take this down close to the first as he's brought down at the Patriots 32. Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. Open man, it's complete to Higgins. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Here we go.
On 1st and 10, Joe Burrow. And a dangerous throw there on the drop-off. Incomplete, nearly intercepted.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
On 2nd and 10, Burrow. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they're going to get this down inside the 20. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Again, it's Burrow. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
They converted twice on 3rd down that drive already, but couldn't make it a 3rd. We always talk about in-game adjustments. How about what the defense did there, able to shut them down on that attempt?
McPherson's kick is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. The catch and run, good for 18 and a 1st down.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Now a pass hauled in downfield. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. It's another 1st down on a big gainer there, 33 yards. Pretty good timing. He waited just enough for that post play to develop and laid it right in there.
And you know what a lot of teams do when they decide to throw a post route? Because it's a little bit longer developing play, and max protect. Bring everyone in, keep the tight end in, an extra back to make sure the quarterback has time to deliver the football.
Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half.
Okay, break.
Now a 1st down carry for Harris. And the 2nd wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
No daylight for him to run through there, and he ran into the defensive tackle, and that guy blocks a whole lot of daylight as it is. He is truly a big man who just made a big play.
On 2nd and 11 now, Hurts. Throw finding Thornton over the middle. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10. The Bengals with 2 extra DBs, a nickel look on 3rd.
Blanket into passing lanes.
Hurts. And this is going to be intercepted. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this 1st half of action. So we are at halftime here on a Monday night as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. So here we go for half number two. The Patriots with the lead, and they will be getting the football. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. Handoff to Harris to begin the drive. And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain, second down.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that huddle right now, but I'll guarantee you at least one offensive lineman is saying, my bad, we simply couldn't move him off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there.
60 Maverick, 60 Maverick. Cut 19, cut 19. Rig, rig.
From the 27, Hurts. And incomplete.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8.
Ring alert, ring alert. 60 Bison, 60 Bison.
Ready? From the gun, it's Hurts. He's got a man, complete. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. A first down and then some, 36 yards. They hand this off to Harris. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
And Brandon, every running back wants to use their speed in order to get out in front of things. Sometimes you just have to be patient, let blocks develop. On that play, that didn't happen.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10.
Drop 50, drop 50.
Ready. They go play action with Hurts. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch, dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. And they move this all the way down to the 9. They'll run on first down. Avery, and he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal.
The yards may start getting a little tougher to come by down here near the goal line. That's good work defensively there on first down, holding them to a short gain.
The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. Hurts sets up to throw it. It's brought in by Harris. Touchdown! Damian Harris, he scored on the ground and through the air. And the Patriots take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes it a 21-10 game. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bengals drive about to get going. They make their second half debut here. Things are looking a little bit tougher now. You give up the points there, Charles, that touchdown drive on the other side. So now it's a 2-score game here. Got to be careful.
They certainly do, and I'm just wondering at halftime if those guys just looked into each other's eyes and realized what they've got to get done and come out a little bit more charged up, because if they don't get some kind of points here, that next drive, that could make this a free possession game.
And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here, up to the 34. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Burrow looking to pass. Got a man. It's Chase. He completes it. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
11, 11. 11, Tommy.
They will throw on first down with Burrow. Wide open receiver complete. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line.
Couple of first downs right in succession, and this is an offense that could really use a good drive, and they're off to a fast start here.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 35-yard line. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. This will be a gain of about 8 to the 27-yard line.
Good yardage there on first down. Exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs. Keep the clock running. If they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 17-yard line. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. From the red zone now, here's Burrow first down. And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
Brandon, once that one broke down, there were only so many options left for him to take. Fortunately, only first down, so he smartly got the yardage he could get and didn't worry about trying to turn into a bigger play and end up taking a bigger loss. Here, they hope they can regroup and get something different going here on second down.
Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
On third down, Burrow. And he fires one that's intercepted. And the Pats are going to take possession here at their own 6-yard line. Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit. And that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned to...
And oh, that is going to be a safety.
The goal here is about getting any kind of positive yardage in this spot, because you don't care who, you don't care how. You just want to try and buy a little space and get away from your own end zone. But in this spot, the defense was all over that play and equally motivated to stick him with a safety.
So free kick situation forthcoming from the 20 as they'll punt this one away. This is taken at the 10. The Bengals drive about to get going. As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding high right now, and they're ready to challenge this offense and that quarterback one more time.
And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in this second half. Now, quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Here's Burrow. Open net is Chase complete. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we...
And now Burrow going to be intercepted yet again. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Patriot defense has a touchdown. Well, Charles, just some visibly frustrated players and coaches on that sideline right now, because those halftime adjustments didn't work. The turnover problems continuing here in the second half, and the defense now sitting pretty comfortably as a result of that pick six.
Hey, that's a great observation too, Brandon, because they did make adjustments at halftime. But how about this other group staying a step ahead despite whatever happened in that other locker room? No surprise they're leading, and it's appropriate that those defenders got to add to the lead directly.
The Bengals drive about to get going. They'll go to work with a little momentum following the free kick, first and 10. And some room to maneuver. And he's out of bounds, but not before a big pickup that time on what's going to wind up being the final play of the third quarter. Back now in Foxborough, it's the Bengals. They've got the football, but they trail here. So the big play moves them all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45. They'll stay on the ground, mix it again. He's got it to the 43 here. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they're going to get this down to about the 37. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
And that one opened up for him well as he'll take this down to the 26-yard line. 87 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. Now, yes, a two-possession game, but a good chunk of time on the clock, so they have the ability still there to run it on second short, but maybe they need to pick it up a bit.
You're right. They did pick up the first down there, but they, as you mentioned, they have to pick up the pace now because it's a two-possession game. They've got to get there twice to make sure they have a chance to win.
They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they're going to get this down inside the 15. Looking to throw again on second down. Burrow. This pass complete to Higgins. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. Burrow hooking up with Higgins for a Bengal first down.
Here we go, here we go. 11.
Back to throw again. That's to Chase. He's got it. Touchdown, Cincinnati. 2 yards on the touchdown there. And the Bengals get a bit closer.
Here we go.
All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. The Burrow's going to look to throw for it. And they're going to get the two. It's caught. So they get the conversion. And now we're back to a one-score game. And that almost makes it a brand-new ball game. Now it's a one-score affair after they get the two.
And you have to know they were holding their breath on the two-point play because they had to have it to get it within the range that you just talked about. Dialed up their two-point play. It worked. Now they're feeling like they've got a shot at this one.
And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
There we go.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first.
Well, it may seem a little unorthodox to some people. Got the lead, fourth quarter, yet he's still firing away. I think he believes that's the best way to go ahead and win the game.
Yeah, a lot of coaches say, let's just run the football, be conservative. He's sticking to his game plan.
No, that is his game, and that's what they're going to ride.
They'll get 13 yards for the second play in a row. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. They'll keep it on the ground. Harris again. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain. I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground. Keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds and let that clock tick.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Off the play fake. Here's Hurts. Right side, Thornton with it. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 37. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35. Now the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit out and running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
Harris going to get it again on second down. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. On the give, this is Harris. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. His carries tonight, they're getting up there, so maybe one of those every now and then is understandable.
I would agree with that. Understandable every now and then. Sometimes you come back and you fake it to him and go play action. But other times you say, okay, they got him on that one. We'll come back to him in another carry.
114 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. And this defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the two-minute warning. Here comes play number nine now as they come up on a third and three. On the draw, it's Harris. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This to perhaps salt this one away. And this one is right through. And that will extend their lead even further. So that one, CD, going to make the road back a lot more difficult.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. You know they were praying on the other sideline for a miss because now, as you pointed out, a very difficult road. Down two scores. You don't just need a touchdown. You need a chain of events to go your way. You've got to score, somehow get the ball back, and score again. The odds of that happening, not great in your favor.
The Bengals drive about to get going.
And as the offense begins another drive here, pretty simple, Charles. They want to carbon copy what happened the last time out when they ended their drive in the end zone.
You're right about that, partner. Sounds pretty simple, doesn't it? Just score again, but we know it's not that simple because we don't just make adjustments at halftime if you're a good football team. You spend that time on the sideline, you study what's on the notes and the tablets, and you make those adjustments.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Adrian Phillips. And the Patriots are going to take possession of the football. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. And we'll see if the defense wants to stop it as they take the knee. Now from the 7, here's second and goal. The Patriots in the victory formation as they'll take the knee. And now can they reverse the trend on third and goal with the last two plays having gone backwards? The Patriots in the victory formation as they'll take the knee.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
So it's a win here for the Patriots, and the guy who really led the way was their quarterback, CD, and that's Jalen Hurts.
Yeah, he really.